Access granted.
Hello there, YouTube. Today we're going to have a look at advanced audio settings in OBS, and it's also where you find the audio sync button and off or offset, you know, so if you have like a delay between your voice on the webcam and the audio. So like if you're talking and your mouth are not synced up and all that, you can do that in there. But let's go in and look at the advanced settings. There's two ways to get in there. Click on this little wheel down here and go into advanced audio properties, or you can go up in edit and advanced audio profiles or properties, sorry. And this is it. So here you have, this is my mic, this is my desktop, the volume, it's the same as down here. You can see it changed, as you can see here. If you want to down mix it to mono, don't use that. Panning, like if you want it to be left or right. And this is the offset that I was talking about. So let's say if you see on a webcam that the mouth, like it is like in an old, like, you know, the old voiceover Japanese movies where the voice is way off the actual movement of the mouth, you can set it off here. Like you can set it down so it will take longer before it comes, or you can push it up so it will so the audio will move further up, like it will come a little bit faster. So think of it like this as like a slider, basically. So I will use this as a representation. So let's say this is your movement of your webcam. Oh, I can't paint it. Can I do this? No. I'll do it down here. So let's say this is your webcam and this is your audio. So if the audio comes before your mouth is speaking, you have to set the offset down, so it will basically come down to here. Whoop. I hope this makes sense for you guys. Let's say your face cam's mouth, like your mouth on the face cam, is speaking before the sound is coming up. You have to push it up. Boop, boop. And by pushing it up, this, you will move the voice up, like the sound of the voice up. I hope this makes sense. Otherwise, you guys can just experiment with it. But it's basically pushing, you know, the sound further to your webcam. So like, so it goes in sync, basically, and it's in milliseconds. I think it's if you're using an Elgato or something like that, you normally need to have like a 4 mil or 100 and something milliseconds delay on sync problem with it. Not delay, but it needs to be synced up with 140 or something like that. I can't remember. This is the tracks. So when you record or you stream with OBS, it actually streams up to 6 different audio pipes, if you can say it like that. And here you tick off what those pipes has to be, what audio that should come through the tracks. So you have track 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and I always have one. It's like my mic, and it's basically mostly for when you're recording. Actually, it's only for when you're local recording. And then I have a track for the desktop. So let's say I record a video, and I only have this one. I will have two tracks, like in DX Story. I will have a mic track, and I will have a video track. A desktop track. And when I'm streaming, you need one where both, like a track where both audios goes into, and that is always track 3 for me. It could be whatever for you guys. And you have to set that when you're setting up your stream. You have to tell it what audio tracks to listen to when you're streaming out, and just remember, it needs to be the same track where you have both tick off. This is for recording purposely only. So you could have like your mic, if you let's say you have two mics, so your mic, your mic, desktop audio, your friend's mic. Let's say you have like a mixer where you also have audio in it and audio, so you can basically, when you are recording, you can extract all these files and you can like individually set like the volume. Let's say your friend's mic was really too low in the game and yours was way too high. After you recorded it, you can just go in and then fix it in a recording software. So I hope all this makes sense to you guys. It's a little bit difficult to explain, but I would really love to like just, if you have problems with it, basically just hit me up and I will show you guys one-on-one how to do it, because it is really easy. It's just like, it's a little bit hard to explain if you don't have someone to tell it to, so you can use their case as an example. But anyway, this is advanced audio properties. So go have an awesome day, and again, use OBS. I will see you all later. Bye-bye.